I know the answer lies in the stones. I know it.
Yeah.
At your service.
Thank you.
yourself a drink. And one for me.
So Tuha's wagers, if one were to bring a pack of armored trolls to break into our vault, our trolls would be the victors in that scenario. Why, you might ask? This one has the answer. Our trolls are vampires.
Since we've had more High Elves and Khajiit around, the food has gotten much more varied in Eldenroot.
Oh, there, adept. Well met, adept. We are in need of your assistance.
Sort of.
Blast has translated Shea Gorath's tome, but we're having some trouble understanding it. She may need your assistance. Seek her out, soon as you can.
Yes, how can I help you? My people mostly leave such matters to our spinners to share, rather than writing it down. I have something, but I can't imagine you'd want Nakaviri spies' writings on our heritage. A cultural infiltration document. Complete garbage. Really? You read Akaviri? Well, no matter. You're welcome to it. Let me see, I have a copy around here somewhere. A moment, please. Here we are. One flawed Akaviri depiction of my people. I hope you find it as amusing as I did.
What do you have there? A book? This book? It's written in Akaviri.
This is wonderful. Nobody here will be able to find the source of my stories if they're written in another language. My Akaviri is a bit stale, but I think I can manage. You're welcome to stay for my performance.
And now, I'd like to present the secret history of the Red Path.
Would you look at that line? We're drawing more people than in Auradon. We'll perform our hearts out. The Wood Elves will see there's more to the Somerset Isles than stuffy politicians. Return anytime you wish. If there's enough call for it, we may have new performances to share.
Behold, another blight upon what was once unbroken green.
Is that Sir Robert's coffin? Oh, my love, they're trained shots.
Gah!
Please get me out of here. I saw what they did to the others. It is a fate worse than death. We fought the worm cultists to the center of Gilvardel, beneath the hollow tree. The Dark Anchor loomed before us, swarming with Daedra, like so many others we'd seen before. But it wasn't long before we realized something was different. We couldn't budge it. Nothing we tried worked. All around it was this feeling, a chill running down our spines. It was his presence, from when he reaped the souls of Gilvardel all those years ago. It's strengthening the Dark Anchor somehow. There are evil devices planted in the earth. The worm cultists call them Fangs of Chaos. They seem to be channeling the residual magic from Molag Bal's presence into the Anchor. Ares tried to destroy one, but it killed him the instant he hit it. I don't know if mortal weapons are useless, if even the most devastating magic fails. What hope do mere mortals have against the Prince of Schemes?
Don't worry, Maeva. I'll see you safely away from this place.
Nonsense. You and your friend here must destroy the Dark Anchor, or the others died in vain.
You always put yourself last, don't you? Maeva's account of the Fangs gives me an idea. Of course, the Fangs. It all makes sense now. Blessed Almalexia had a vision that the Prince of Schemes had sunk his teeth into the ground at Gilvardel. The Fangs she saw in her vision must be the devices Maeva described. Have you ever seen a goddess cry? It is a terrible thing to behold. So perfect a face, marred by so many tears. Almalexia's tears for Gilvardel crystallized into a beautiful gem, filled with all her fury directed at the Harvester of Souls. A goddess never suffers without purpose. The gem can destroy the Fangs of Chaos. Blessed Almalexia warned me that no mortal could wield the gem without also being destroyed by her rage. She told me to wait for the soulless, deathless one, you. Take Almalexia's tear, destroy the worm cultists. Their blood will awaken her fury. Once my goddess's fury is released from the gem, nothing, not even these Fangs of Chaos, will withstand it. I will remain at your side to see this through.
I can make my way to the shore on my own. No doubt you will cause quite the distraction.
Very well. Let's go.
Ah! is no time for idle talk. We need to destroy the fangs of chaos to weaken the dark anchor.
Thank you.
It is done. The Harvester of Souls' presence is receding from the land, though it is likely that this place will be forever scarred. They will try, but without the Daedra or the link to Cold Harbor, destroying the remaining worm cultists will be quick work. I will warn the Dominion of what they attempted with the Fangs of Chaos. It will not be allowed to happen again. I must send word to the Dominion of what transpired here. Almalexia sees great things from me, but whether good or bad, I can't say. Thank you for your help. If we meet again, I hope it is as allies once more. Farewell.
You return. Did you have any luck finding the remaining fragments? Enough! This is more than I even dreamed of. I think this might even allow me to piece together the complete tablet. Variations in the runes, slightly altered structure. Yes, yes, this is very exciting. Thank you. A find like this is incredibly rare. It could greatly advance our understanding of the Valenwood Aliads and their unique dialect. I must begin translating immediately. Everyone knows the Aliads left many secrets behind. And the more we understand about them, the more we learn about what remains. Their language is part of this. And as the Aliads migrated and split, variations of their language emerged. Correct. We already know there were cultural differences between the Aliads of Cyrodiil and those that settled in Valenwood. Their language varies too, and is less understood than the more common Cyrodiilic. Any writing we find here is significant.